Hello, hello. Going to be doing a few different screen recording videos today. Something I just found out about was Tesla's privacy data, whatnot associated with your account. So if we go up to, if you open your browser, go up to tesla.com/support/privacy. You can obtain a copy of the data associated with your Tesla account. So part of putting you in control of your data and privacy, Tesla gives you the ability to request a copy of the data associated with your Tesla account. Access to this feature varies by location, so depending on which country you are in and possibly even which state if you're in the USA. So we're going to go down, learn how to request a copy of your data. The data associated with your account. Order details, account information, customer support activity, service history. Now that is a very important one. You're going to want service history. Tesla natively tries to make this disappear pretty quick from your app. I think after a year, your service history is not shows doesn't show anything over a year in your app in most cases. And after that, you have to request it from the service center. And further yet, Tesla switched systems in 2019. So everything prior to that is either no longer accessible or very hard to access. Basically, Tesla started back in 2012. They were using it. SpaceX software for their service and ticketing system, which was never quite designed to handle the volume of tickets and service information that they ended up having, so they had to switch systems. So order in our service history, you need a folder on your computer with all of that saved. If you don't want to do it on your computer, put all those PDFs, email them to yourself, they're not very big, and create a separate folder on your email service, Yahoo, Google, for example, to store all that in. Vehicle usage information, I'm not sure what that all includes quite yet. Safety, event camera recordings, if applicable. So, say there was an accident and there was camera recordings, that may show up here. Infotainment system settings information, interesting. Mobile, oh, that might lead to possibly portable, portable settings from vehicle to vehicle, tied to the person. Mobile app usage information and supercharging history. Not as important for those who have free supercharging forever, but for those that pay per use, that might be something good, works like a receipt. When you request a copy of your data, we first verify that you are the account holder making the request. So basically, you log into your account, which I've already done, so that way I don't have to do that on screen for you all. You have 7 days to download your data, after which time it is removed from that location and you'll need to request it again. Downloading your data does not delete it from Tesla service servers. Tesla strives to collect and store the minimum amount of data required to provide the services you use. Therefore, when data isn't provided, it's because it is either in a form that is not personally identifiable or linked with your Tesla account. It is stored in an end-to-end encryption format that Tesla cannot decrypt. It is not customer-related. Is not stored by Tesla at all, or it is not currently part of a standard request. Additionally, some data may have been held for only a very short time and is no longer on our servers. So basically, they might have had some data that has then been deleted. Let's see. You can refer to Tesla's privacy notice if you want, even though, okay, there we go, legal, blah, blah, blah. If you want to see that, tesla.com/legal. How to request a copy of your data. Go to tesla.com/contact us and sign into your Tesla account. And then use the form below to contact the support team. Choose your topic, data, privacy request. Okay, obtain a copy of my data. And I would like to obtain a copy of my vehicle data from the last and then number of days. Step 3, verify your request and notify you by email when your data is ready. Reminder, this process can take up to 30 days. Interesting. About the data Tesla provides. Sentry mode recordings processed. I'm not going to read everything here. You can pause the video, take a look. Touchscreen interactions. Interesting. So they know what you click on. Oh, FedEx just stopped by. I will go down. I'll let you all read all this fun stuff on your own. Delete your Tesla account. Tesla gives you the ability to permanently delete your account. So if you want to part ways with Tesla, you can delete your account, and it is supposed to delete absolutely everything. Don't do this unless you're absolutely sure. I think they should make that a little harder to just delete your account. I don't know if it's a legal thing. Because if someone were to get your username and password, they could potentially delete your account. And that's all gone. Frequently asked questions. Should use a Mac or a PC. Let's just expand all those again. Pause video and you can read. There's also an event data recorder. First, we're going to do the data request, and then we'll touch on the event data recorder. So now you're going to go to tesla.com/contact us. I just opened in a new tab, which popped up over here. It's going to, if you're not already, it'll ask you to log in, which I pre-did, so that way, I mean, you don't need to see me type in a username and password. So choose your topic. Data privacy request. Obtain a copy of my data. You can also say delete account. Correct my data. Communication preferences. Your vehicles. This is the list of all vehicles associated with your account. Whoa. Hello. Oh, there's my... It's got the model, my Model X Founders that I had to resell. But it doesn't have my first Model S. Interesting. And I only had this car for a day. Not even. I've never actually even physically touched it because I had to flip it to be able to afford my Model S. Well, there's my P85. That's my 2012. Let's do my Model S 90D because that's the one I use the most. And date range to May 3rd. Let's see how far back. Can't select years. Got to keep doing this. 19. Let's see if we can go back to 2016 when I picked it up. I guess production date. So it won't let me go past the production date. So let's go back to then, January 5th, 2016, May 3rd. This process can take up to 30 days. Let's submit. Request sent. Oh, it doesn't wipe everything out. All right, let's do Model X. See how far back that'll let us go, oh, not, well, definitely won't let me go back to production date on the Model X. I did buy that one used. So let's go back to, I'll probably go to when it was added to my account. We'll go back to January 2019. That's unusual because I didn't buy it yet. Let's see if it'll give me information that was under the previous owner. Oh, request sent. I'm going to have to refresh. Darn it. Data privacy request. Select vehicle. To just before COVID started. Yep, won't let me do 18, but it'll let me do January 1st, 2019, which is, well, let's see, my daughter was born on March 29th, 2019, and I picked it up about 2 weeks before then. Okay, let's try all four cars. I don't know why the my Founders Model X would even be on here. Let's do my P85, which has only been on my account a couple weeks. I don't even have it yet. Holy moly. Well, let's see if it will let us, how far I'll go back. I mean, I've only had it on my account and ownership for about a month. That's letting me go back to 2019 too. All right, let's do it. I'd be really curious if it gives me information from the previous owner or owners. And data privacy request, the last one. Select vehicle. Let's try the Founders. I mean, I should have pretty much nothing for the Founders. And nope, there we go. It's not letting me select any dates. It's only letting me select today. So, well, let's try it. We got them all. Got them all. Let's, what did I get? Oh, additional verification required. As part of putting you in control of your data and privacy, Tesla gives you the ability to request a copy of the data associated. First, we must verify you are the account holder making the request. To verify your identity, please provide you with the request data. Please reply with the following information. Did I not just do this over here? All right, well, I guess I will have to send all this to Tesla and see if I get a response. I get a few other things. Yep, they're going to want request for everything. All right, so it looks like I will not be able to get the Founders then. Oh. And I don't know how far back I can get for the P85. So I will give it a try. But that is how you request the data for your vehicles. And that is it. Next, we're going to touch on the event data recorder, which I didn't even know we had access to, although it's not cheap, but in an accident in some situation, that might be pertinent, and your insurance might cover that, possibly. So, all right, that's it for this. See you next video.